What's up, y'all? This is Hussein Nasser from iGeometry, where we discuss software engineering by example. In this episode, we will discuss how to build a Python web server, a very simple Python web server using Tornado as the web server logic there. So before we jump into that, we're going to discuss what we're exactly going to build. I'm going to show you the examples. We're going to show you four benefits of the web server. So the web server can be used to serve static files like a blog or a static HTML page, CSS, JavaScript. Could be used to build APIs, right? You can build your put your Python code at the back end and serve it with the HTTP protocol, right? Build API, microservices, all this cool stuff. You can use it to build proxy servers and other much cool applications as well. So with that, let's just jump into it. So first example here. So we will show how to serve basic content. Like, so you listen to the web server. So this is a web server that is running on Tornado. So you can just click there and then serve simple static text, right? So I'm just returning hello world as a text. Another way of things is you can use it to serve static content. Like, I'm gonna serve my blog, I'm gonna serve an index.html file or any HTML file that has CSS, has JavaScript and other stuff. So that's another HTML file that I'm serving using the same web server. Another thing is I want to use it to build an API. So this is a simple API that I built to just tell you if a number is an even or not. So it's not really complex stuff, but it tells you the idea here. So just as an example, so you can see that I have a method here called isEven. You pass it a query string. That's what it's called, a query string. And then you can pass a number, and then it tells you if the number is odd or even or whatever, right? So that's we'll learn how to pull these query strings from Python. So that's, and the final way is to use the same kind of API, but it's like cooler, using the resource parameter. So it's like if you are familiar with Twitter, so Twitter are using the resource parameter, like it's just like a tweet, give me tweet number 9912, whatever, right? And then you can use this ID to query a database and do cool stuff. YouTube use the same kind of a string resources here. All right, let's jump into the actual coding. What are you gonna need, guys? You're gonna need Python installed, right? And with that, you're gonna need pip installer, and you're gonna need to install Tornado. So I have already installed Tornado, so I'm gonna just show you how to do it here. Tornado, pip install Tornado, says already satisfied. Once you do that, you are ready, right? So you go ahead. The second step is to pick up your favorite text editor. Mine is Visual Studio Code. You can use PyCharm. You can use any text editor that understands Python. I like Visual Studio Code because it's very light and it has syntax highlighting. It takes care of all these. It has debugging and so many cool stuff as well. So I like to use Visual Studio Code here. So I'm gonna go ahead and open a new folder. Let's create a new project here. Let's call it pyweb, whatever. And we'll go ahead and open that. What we need to do is create a Python file. Let's call it index.py. And since we have installed Tornado, all we have to do is import tornado.web. And then we're going to import another library that we're going to use, tornado.ioloop. So the web is, we're going to use it for the handlers. So guys, if you remember, the handlers are what we explained here. So we have four handlers that we explained here. Okay, all of them actually pour into the abstract handler, which is called the request handler. But there are different methods if you think about it. Okay, where's my Visual Studio Code? Where are you? There you go. Okay, so the IO loop will keep, this is the loop that the thread keep listening to the request that is coming, essentially, and it will be used to listen on a port. Okay, so with that, I need to basically check if I am executing on the main right. Once I am executing on the main, what I want to do is create an app here, and the app is tornado.web. Oops, tornado. Come on, tornado.web.application. Wonder why it's not working. Okay, so the application here takes an array of what we call the request handlers. So each request handler is a tuple, essentially. So this is, let's do the first one, which is the hello world. Remember, guys, the hello world was just the slash. Like, if someone visited my root, do that, okay? So let's do this basic stuff. If someone visited my root, I want to execute a request handler, which was, well, let's call it the basic request handler. How about that? Request handler, okay? And obviously this doesn't exist, right? So we need to create that class, right? So what we're gonna do is basically inherit from tornado.web.requestHandler, okay? And just like that, we got an instance, essentially a class which inherits from this request handler, which is the basic request handler. And we're gonna define a method, get, and that takes a self, and what the get is actually the method that gets executed, the HTTP method, right? So you can have get, post, options, header, so many methods, right? But we're interested in get only for now. So let's go and write back hello world. Okay. But we forgot to do something very important here. You'll notice that I use a lot of semicolons here because I'm coming from a C# background and JavaScript, so I'm just like add semicolons left and right. So we forgot to actually listen to the app here. So let's listen to the port 8881, wherever. So to start the thread, we need to do tornado.io loop.get the current thread, and then just go ahead and start it. So that will start up our tornado app, essentially. So, but I wanted to print something that just to tell us, like, hey, I'm listening on port 8881. You can just, guys, you can do it in a variable and just do it that. That's the correct way of doing things. So basic request handler, let's check that out. We can even start debugging from here, right? And do Python, that will tell us I'm listening on port 8881. So let's check that out, 8881. There you go. I remember this many bangs, that's what I did. Okay, let's stop that and let's do another handler, guys. Let's do something more fun. Let's do the static handler, which is the like serving an HTML file, right? Let's say I am creating an HTML file here. Let's call it index.html, and we're gonna do like, that's the cool thing about Visual Studio Code. It allows just like to put boilerplate code. If you guys didn't catch that, just the HTML:5 and just tap, and then we'll just do that. So welcome to my blog, guys, and we just like, I don't know, make it header 1, right? Anything. What we're gonna do here, guess what? This is an array, just add another entry, and says, hey, I want the blog entry to go to this handler. Let's call it static request handler. Okay, and then you just copy and paste if you don't remember that stuff. Let's call it static handler, right? Instead of doing self.write, we will do self.render, which is essentially rendering a file that is in the same directory, which is as the one you're running, essentially. Index.py, index.html. Go ahead and render and return this to the client, okay? All right, let's go ahead and start that. Maybe I'll just move this here. All right, so we have 8881 is the root, slash blog gives me welcome to my blog, guys. All right, so that's the HTML file we served. Cool. All right, let's do something more. Let's do the function as even or as prime, right? You can do any function here. And we're going to do the query string now. So another request handler will be slash is even. If someone visited the slash is even handler, we will call query string request handler. And then, okay, this doesn't exist, obviously. What we're going to do is steal from here, paste, and then we call this query string request handler. And then guess what, guys? So now, we can get that parameter or argument, right? Remember, guys, because this is how we do it, right? We're going to pass it as a query parameter using this question mark parameter. So we're going to do in dot equal self dot get argument, and let's say I'm assuming I'm getting argument n, and I want n to be always an integer, so sure, let's do that. And then we'll type in a result here. So it says it will r is odd, which is the result is odd if n modulo 2. Okay, I think that will work. Else even. So that's just a ternary operator there. And we can say the number, and that's the cool thing about this, the number n is is r, which is whatever. It could be even or odd. Okay, you get the idea, guys, right? You can use this to do whatever you want. And refresh, that's the blog, that's the resource, is even, n is equal 8. 8 is even, it is even, sir. And you can put any number there and just take it. We'll take it. Guys, I'm gonna put the GitHub repo for this code if you want, guys, in the description below, so don't worry, it's like you can pause if you want. I like to start from scratch all the time in my old examples. Okay, final thing, resource string, which is a cooler way of doing things, I guess. All right, I did a video to do the difference. Like if you want to know the difference between resource string and query string, or query parameter and resource parameter, just click here. I'll reference it somewhere in the cards, so you can just take a look at the video that I did. Okay, let's do the tweet, for example, right? Or could be books. You just like you get the user will say tweet and then the ID. So we're expecting a number here, right? Right. So you're expecting a number, and what you will pass is essentially what do you call a regular expression here. So expect telling this thing that hey, I'm gonna give you a number, so expect a number. And this is how you do a number in regular expression. So 0 to 9 and 1 or more. Okay. You do that, and then you say resource. Let's call it resource request handler. Right? Let's do a resource handler. Where's that thing? Let's copy from this guy. So the cool thing about this, this is slightly different, if you notice, guys. So this is going to be slightly different. This, the parentheses, will tell this handler that, hey, expect another parameter. Let's call this resource handler. Okay. Expect another handler, which is whatever. We're going to call it ID. Okay. And then querying tweet with ID. So it's like, if you think about it, it's like a little cleaner, I think. So you can just clearly see your parameters here, right? Instead of using the get argument, because you have no idea what's the schema kind of a thing, right? For your stuff. But how about we try this out, guys? How about we try this out? Let's try this out. Let's give it a shot. And then that's our even. And then you do tweet slash 9, right? 8, right? So those example doesn't seem very cool, but it will allow you to do like a boilerplate and actually do some work. And like what you would do essentially is like put the ID, get it, actually make a query to the Twitter API, and then get the information displayed to the user, right? You can do more cool stuff. All right, guys, that is all for me. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Check out the other content of this channel. Subscribe to this channel. I talk about software engineering. That's my specialty here. I talk about software engineering by example. That's just one example of the code where we sit down and actually do some code. Python, I took JavaScript, C# tutorials, we have VB stuff, we talk about a lot of software, interesting software engineering concepts as well. So check out the content if you enjoy it, and I'm gonna see you in the next one. You guys stay awesome.